So Richard Wilde, he's got the voice, he's got some 10 out of 10 outfits, but the music videos, they were a bit trippy, to say the least. Travelers of the ocean.
Oh. Oh, goodness me. Well, this was the first ever song that I recorded, which we've included as a bonus track. Jared, my friend and first ever manager, who drove me from Palmerston North up to Auckland to audition for that Smile show, wrote this. I recorded this in the studio as a demo to bring to Australia to show them what I was made of.
Look at that boyish charm. Those are some tight pants, and suddenly your whole existence makes sense.
They said, don't pay us the $130 for the session and we'll release it as a single. So they did, and it became up half a hit, and that's what sort of started the whole thing. That was a suit I had. It was, oh, geez.
Wow.
It was a top half to that.
You can see what you had for breakfast.
Oh, yeah, and dinner. It's a bit clunky, but it's quite a catchy song.
I really like that every song, clearly, you've been like, and now it's time for the violin solo.
Well, if you got it, flaunt it, you know what I mean?
And boy, are you flaunting
and
it.
And the violence. See, Rod Stewart used to wear scarves all
yeah,
the time.
Yeah, it's a bit Tom Petty, too.
Well, I wish. The sky was the limit with the budget on this thing.
Mate.
That was a suit. Okay. Well, this was about 1976. That was a violin that my mum gave me that I learnt on.
Slipping away. Look at that hair. Is that Pantene? The correct answer is yes.
Well, it didn't happen overnight, did it?
It did happen.
Gee. Wow, it was all on show there, wasn't it?
What is going on there?
Well, gee.
How old are you here?
You all right? No, I'm 22, though. 23. Yeah.
You like a hard finish, don't you?
Oh, well, there you go. Summer of Love, 1977. We're all obviously miming this thing. Here for a Good Time was about to be released, and was into an empty club to sing along with ourselves.
The kimono here is fantastic, and if we could locate it, I would wear it constantly.
Yeah.
A short chartreuse kimono never goes out of fashion.
Is this the one with the dragon embroidered on the
Not
back?
Not a long time. Who are these people? That is such a good outfit.
Thank you. I remember the bass player's name was Peter Solomon. Paul McCartney was his favorite act. This guy is a great guitarist, and he didn't come on the road with us, although I wanted him to. And the keyboard player who played the Fender Rhodes, I think he was dating the girl singer.
I just love how much of this shot is consumed by the roof.
It was a great roof.
Like,
it was a very busy roof.
It really needed some emphasis.
I don't know why we didn't get some punters in there.
Not a long time.
She gets more close-ups than me. What's going on?
Well, when you spent that much money to have a pound
like
that.
It's got long hair, this guy. That's my violin.
Busting out
Look
the violin.
Look at the roof. Why the roof?
You really liked an undershot.
I was just...
Oh, look at you staring off there.
I didn't know what I was doing.
Playing your guitar. It's like there.
In this crazy city. She gets all the close-ups. Long close-ups. Really long close-ups.
Like, was there a thing between her and the videographer?
Maybe. I remember when we were on the road, our drummer Noel got sick one night and couldn't play, so I ended up playing drums for a show myself.
How'd that go?
It was okay. Didn't want to give the money back, you know? No one likes cancelling a show. It was really exciting though. We didn't know what was around the corner, and we had this band we were about to head off. It was the Richard Wilde Band around New Zealand in 100 days. 100 days on tour. It's a third of a year, you know, away from home. Everyone lets their flats go and stuff. Chuck our stuff in the back of a van that I just bought for the tour. And that was that.
Look at the happy clappers.
Big sing-along at the end. Oh, an all-star finale. Oh my goodness. I have not seen this. In fact, I thought this was gone. This was the van I bought. I went and bought a van.
Richard Wilde Roadshow.
That was Richard Wilde Roadshow.
This is very Trump of you. How good's a power ballad? Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot about that. I think that's the one and only time I've ever had my hair permed.
You look slightly as if Ellen DeGeneres was dressing up as an 80s pop star.
Is that good or bad?
You decide.
Yeah, I told you, around New Zealand, and oh, that was a double neck guitar I bought.
Oh, that's fun. Where's that?
I don't know. Yeah.
And a Perspex drum kit.
Yeah, multi-coloured, mind you.
You had some very fun instruments.
12-string guitar, violin.
Oh, and your violin.
Had lights.
And you had someone turning knobs.
Yeah. And it was in the studio, too. We're all over the shop here. Oof. It's not a bad song, eh? Mike Harvey wrote this. Producer, arranger guy. Oh, attaboy. Who's that?
Your soundo is getting a close-up. I love it.
What's the soundo getting a close-up? This is the recording equipment. Look at that. You don't see stuff like, here, more ceiling. Why are the ceilings getting such attention? Where's the van?
Yeah, where's the Richard Wilde Roadshow? Maybe I should re-record these.
It's a good song. I don't know if you can sing that part.
Nah.
Neither I can either. Yes, that's, seriously, that's...
We're choosing to feature on some really odd things.
It was 20 past 11 when we recorded this.
Here are my sunglasses. Picking up, putting them down. Who's that?
That's me. I'm proud to be Kenton. What?
Don't know if you'd get away with that shot these days.
Who are these people? Some old bloke in a park.
You have absolutely just approached random people.
Why did I do that?
Here, Richard Wilde is in the wild.
So this is 1978. We were obviously on tour when someone decided to, and Mr. Spielberg decided to come down and shoot us. Oh, wouldn't
I really love you clutching on to your headphones too.
Thank you. Richard Wilde, isn't it? Oh, I'm glad that's over. It's very high.
This is It's Magical, which I reckon could be my favorite music video.
Really?
Yeah. You look good there.
I think that's an owl.
What was with the owl? Or is that a cat?
I don't know. When we put this whole thing together, I'd honestly forgotten entirely about this song. It was written by a guy called Russ Ballard, who's a great writer. Wrote for a guy called Colin Blunstone, wrote songs for Kiss and a whole lot of people. It was produced by a guy called Dale Wrightson. He was a big advertising guy in Auckland. That's an owl.
That's an owl. That's fantastic. I don't know why it's there.
Because it's magical. No answer for that. This is prior to MTV, ladies and gentlemen. You must remember that. Oh, here we go.
So did MTV really kind of change the game when it came to music videos?
Yeah, what do you reckon? Oh, dear.
There you are.
Yeah, I have absolutely zero.
What are you looking at, too?
I'm looking at the owl. Yeah, MTV. I mean, music videos were a sort of an afterthought of something you may or may not do. But when MTV came along in the early 80s, suddenly that became an art form in itself.
This is like if a mood ring was a music video.
When they used to shoot the screen and get all that. It sort of looks like an accident, doesn't it?
And under the chin shot is definitely a choice.
Yeah. What am I wearing? It's all right.
Yeah, I like this one.
It's magical.
Oh, Mariah Carey, your heart out.
I think that was the owl. Gee whiz. Wow. This would have.
Who would you say that your biggest influences were?
The owl. you know. I don't know. I just love good, catchy pop song. I loved artists like, Rod Stewart was such a powerful force at the time in my little world. Just writing catchy pop songs and living a dream and traveling the world.
It must have been pretty great when you kind of got to meet him and become a bit friendly.
Yeah, he's a lovely man, Rob. Yeah, gee, this is a pretty trippy video. Not really a theme going on here.
No. Colours.
No wonder I haven't seen it before. I don't know if it ever got played on telly. I was always fortunate enough to have great players, great session players, great bands, great musos.
It's magical.
Very good. Okay, moving right along.
Lucky us.
Oh, goodness.
I haven't seen this one. So what's this?
This is in Australia. We're now in Australia. This is Wilde and Reckless. We did a 6-track EP. And we're out.
Is this like a World War II?
It's a song called She's Good to Me, written by a guy called Chris Pelser. Full of.
Oh.
Yeah, full of sort of aeronautical imagery.
So we were hooking up, we were going to war, then we were flying, now we've landed.
No, we're out at Sydney Airport, which felt like a big deal at the time, because they had models and planes and.
But how, are we about to take off or have we just arrived?
Wait and see, no spoilers here.
I feel like I now understand you so much better because you spend a lot of time at airports and you've always loved skinny pants.
There you go. So MTV was still just around the corner. See, there's me in a plane. Might even be. We were really up there in the air.
Wow.
Lady Jane Beach, see all this imagery? She's good
to me. Under chin shots. So who cares if we fall to the sea? It's now that matters. She's good to me.
The world's a freeway. That was the cover of our 6-track album. It was Wayne, the bass player, came from New Zealand with me. It's Dave Dempsey, guitarist. Great guitarist, though. There he is playing guitar on a plane. That's no easy feat.
How much does this music video cost? This definitely has the highest production value.
Yeah, kidding, we're in a plane.
We've gone from shots of the roof to the sky's the limit.
Exactly. I remember hearing this getting played on Triple M. It was like,
Triple M.
Yeah, exactly. They back it out and say, that's wild and reckless. Who are well and truly on the way.
To Kingsford Smith Airport.
See, look, they had set pieces and...
Oh my God. The French are invading.
French?
Yeah.
They'd never invade.
I know.
Here we go.
He's a good looking rooster. Who's that?
Les?
What's Les doing now?
That's Wayne. His name may not be Les.
Wayne's enjoyed a cigarette or two and some time in the sun, eh?
He was from Palmerston North, New Zealand. He traveled the distance with me. That was my jacket I wore for that. Ooh, here we go.
Oh, no!
Yeah, we're down.
Who put Richard in charge of the plane?
I'm singing along as the plane plummets into the ground.
And you're thinking of your one true love. No wonder you look so disheveled.
Not a bad song, huh?
Yeah. She's good to me. She's good to Richard.
Yeah, we're out in the middle of Sydney Airport. They wouldn't let you do that today. Well, there you go.
Back in 1700s, there was only one or two flights coming in.
That's true.